in lesson 1 by mistake in the group of consonants one group has been left out, that is coalescence. C O A L E S C E N T S. Coalescence. There is a verb in English. Coalesce means to unite or join together. In this group, there are two consonants, W and Y. W is pronounced as way, as you hear in the word wage. Y is pronounced as yellow, as you hear in the word. It is pronounced as ye, and as you hear in the word, ello. So this I had left out, so please make a correction. Now, lesson 2, that is vowels. We have learnt the consonants in the previous lessons and also the conditions to join the consonants. Now, we have to construct the words. To construct a word, we have to add vowels to the consonants. So, we should learn as to how to mark the vowels so that we can construct words. For every consonant, there are three places to mark the vowels: in the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. The vowels may be marked both at the left hand side and also the right hand side. In case of horizontal strokes, it may be marked upward and downward. The oval place counting starts from the place where we begin to write the consonant. We write P from upward to downward. The counting starts from upward to downward. A ray, we write from downward to upward. The counting starts from downward to upward. Curved strokes, both left hand side and right hand side, we can mark the vowels. In case of horizontal strokes, the vowels are marked from left to right, and both upward and downward we can mark the vowels. If we mark the vowel at the beginning, it is called as first place vowel. If we mark the vowel in the middle, it is called the second place vowel. If we mark the vowel at the end, it is called third place vowel. Now, we should know when we have to mark the vowel at the left hand side and when we have to mark the vowel at the right hand side. If a vowel precedes a consonant, it is called preceding vowel, P-R-E-C-E-D-I-N-G, preceding vowel, and in such case, vowel is marked at the left hand side of the consonant. If a vowel follows a consonant, the vowel is marked at the right hand side of the consonant. In case of horizontal stroke, preceding vowel is marked upwards and following vowel is marked at the downward side. Now let us see how to mark the vowels so that we can construct the words. First place vowels. The vowels which are marked in the beginning are called first place vowels. The first place vowels are A and A, dash vowel A, dash vowel A. I will write the corresponding sound in Hindi also so that for other students who are from north side, they can also understand. A, A, dash vowel A, dash vowel A. A, this one, A is represented by a thin dot marked at the beginning, either at the left side or right side, depending upon whether it is a preceding vowel or a following vowel. Examples for vowel A, as you hear in the word act, here the sound is A plus T. Here the vowel A is preceding the consonant T. So it is a preceding vowel. So this vowel has to be marked at the left hand side at the beginning, that is first place. Here you have to mark thin dot here. See the other examples. Pack. Here after P the vowel A is coming. So it is a following vowel. It is marked at the right hand side. In case of horizontal, example map, here the sound is M plus A plus P, M P. Here this is a horizontal stroke. In case of horizontal stroke, if the following vowel comes, it has to be marked downward at the first place. If it is a preceding vowel, it is marked above. Example in the word am, before am you mark the vowel at the first place. Now the second vowel, a dash vowel a, it is marked by a light dash in the beginning. The difference between a dot vowel and a dash vowel A can be known by the following example. See the word tap. Here, dot. You compare tap with top, T-O-P, top. Here, there is O in the spelling. We are getting A sound from O in the spelling. In such case, we mark a thin dash to represent one, so that we can distinguish between the word tap and top. Other examples are CAP, cap, KP, dot oval, COP, cop, dash oval. LACK, lack, LOCK, lock. LACK, lack, it is dot oval. LOCK, lock, it is dash oval. KNACK, knack. N and K after N, downward, dot oval. KNOCK, knock. N and K, dash oval. HACK, hack. HACK, hack, dot. HOCK, hawk, it is dash oval. In case of other consonant, PBTD, etc., the dash oval is marked horizontally. For example, like this. Horizontally. In case of horizontal strokes like N, M, etc., while marking a dash oval, it is marked perpendicularly, not horizontally. Next, the example for O, long oval. It is represented by a thick dot in the beginning. For example, PA, P, and then for O sound, it is a long oval. We write a thick dot. Paul, P and L, thick dot. Shah, S-H-A-H, Shah. You write thick dot. Next, the example for dash oval, long oval, or dash oval, long oval, or. You compare these words. P-A, pa, P-A-W, pa. Here, from AW is there, oval. In such cases, in the word AW is there, that oval is called a dash oval. If there is AU, AW, AL, etc. in the spelling, if you are getting the long oval A, it should be represented by a thick dash. Thick dot is marked when there is A or double A in the spelling, then we write the thick dot. You see the other example. Pierre, Paul, thick dot, but P-A-U-L, Paul, that is A-U in the spelling. So you write a thick dash. M-A-L, Mall, write M and L, thick dot. But M-A-U-L, Mall, you write M and L, A-U, you write a thick dash. The other examples for long oval, dash oval A is SHAH, compare SHAH, SHA, it is dot. SHAW, SHA, here AW is there, you have to write a thick dash. LAW, law, AW is there, you write a thick dash to represent dash oval A. RAW, raw, AW is there, you write thick dash. G-N-A-W, here in this word, G is silent, it is pronounced as na, A-W is there, you write a tick dash. T-A-L-K, talk, when there is A-L and when L is not pronounced, then it is represented by a tick dash. So that is the difference between O long oval, dash oval, or. The dash oval, as I have already explained, it is marked always horizontally to the straight stroke and curved strokes. But for horizontal stroke, dash oval should always be written with perpendicular direction. So now we have learned first place ovals. Now it is second place ovals. That is, ovals which are marked in the middle, they are called as second place ovals. The second place ovals are A and A, O and then O, corresponding in Hindi A, A, O, and O. So, A is represented by writing a thin dot in the middle. A long oval is represented by a thick dot in the middle. O is represented by placing a thin dash in the middle. The long oval O is represented by writing a thick dash in the middle. Now, the examples for A, the first one, the example for A, as in the, here in the word, ab, the sound is A plus B. You write B, before B, A is there, it is a preceding vowel. For A, what you have to write? Thin dot. You write a thin dot in the middle, that is ab. E, T, C, H, H, A plus Ch. You write Ch, before Ch, A sound. You write a thin dot. B, E, G, beg. B plus A plus G. B and G. After B, you write a thin dot in the middle. Leg, L, E, G. L plus A plus G. L and G, you write thin dot in the middle. Bet, B, E, T, bet. B plus A plus T. B and T, after B, you write a thin dot. So, we have learnt how to mark A. Now, the long vowel A, as I already told you, it is represented by writing a thick dot in the middle. The example, D-A-Y, day, D plus A. After D vowel is there, it is the following vowel. You mark thick dot at the right hand side. A-I-D, aid, A plus D. Before D, there is a thick dot. A vowel is there, you write a thick dot. Bake, B plus A plus K. B and K, you write a thick dot. In case of horizontal, preceding vowel is marked upward and following vowel marked downwards, as in make, M-A-K-E, make. M plus A plus K, M and K. After M, A vowel is there, following, you mark it downward. Aim, A plus M. Before M, A vowel is there, it is the preceding vowel, mark it upward. So we have learnt A and A, short vowel and long vowel, A and A. Next is O sound, the short vowel O. It is represented by writing a small dash in the middle, as you hear in the word T-U-B, tub, C-U-B, cub, T-U-G, tug, M-U-G, mug, H-U-G, hug, L-U-N-C-H, lunch, M-U-N-C-H, munch, etc. Now, in all these words, you can see one common thing, that is, there is U in the spelling. T-U-B, tub, C-U-B, cub, T-U-G, tug, M-U-G, mug, H-U-G, hug, L-U-N-C-H, lunch, M-U-N-C-H, munch. So, there is U in the spelling. When we pronounce as though there is A sound. But if you hear a British man pronouncing these words, he will stylishly pronounce as though there is O sound. If you say tub, they pronounce it as tob, cob, tor, mob, hob, etc. So when there is U in the spelling, it should be treated as stylish O pronunciation, and it is represented by a thin dash in the middle. T-B, tub, thin dash in the middle. Cub, K and B. K is a horizontal stroke. The following vowel is marked downward and in case of horizontal strokes, dash oval is marked perpendicularly. Tug, T and G, dash oval. Mug, here M is a horizontal stroke, so O is marked downward and the dash oval is marked perpendicularly. Hug, he, G, hug, dash oval. Lunch, L, N, Ch, dash oval. Munch, M, N, Ch, M is a horizontal stroke, so dash oval is marked perpendicular. Now, the example for long vowel O. As you hear in the word, D-O-O-R, door. D, we hear O, long vowel, and then R, D, downward R, O sound. S-H-O-R-E, shore, ish, plus O, show, R. Ish, downward R, O sound, shore. More, M-O-L-E, M plus O plus L, M, L, M is a horizontal stroke and dash oval O is marked perpendicularly. Goal, G-O-A-L, G plus O plus L, G, L, it is marked perpendicularly. Joke, J plus O plus K, J and K, O sound, joke. So now we have learnt all the second place over, saying the O and O. Now, third place ovals. The ovals which are marked at the end, they are called as third place ovals. They are E and E, U and U, corresponding E and E, U and woo. E is represented by thin dot, E is represented by thick dot, U is represented by thin dash,